Hi. A woman on Instagram just said that she's starting to agree with me because she's been watching my videos on YouTube. She thinks that I'm much better at speaking and having my personality come across than writing. And I have been told that some before, and women tell me that they love my videos, but according to the numbers, people seem to like my writing a lot more. I know I'm not a public speaker. I think, you know, my thoughts get jumbled and they come out of my mouth. I'm thinking ahead of my thought, what I'm saying. And I watch some of my videos back. I'm just like, oh no, you know. But I started making videos years ago because I felt like I wanted people to see my personality and that I'm not out again, you know, I'm not out to get anyone or ill will. I have no ill will towards people like many have towards me. I was taught from a child to love people, even my enemies. And so I do. I don't remember ever hating anybody. I pity people, you know, those who are so adamant against God's ways, but I certainly don't hate them. I don't like that the things that they slander me and mock me about. But I just have to ping those up to the Lord and not allow them to steal my joy. I was at a funeral last weekend, and a woman there grabbed my arm when I was leaving. I knew her from years ago. They attended our church, and she started talking about my viral post. She knew all about, you know, my writings, my blogs, and she has a blog and she teaches doctrine. And she made a comment that I just can't be as, what was the word she used? It was on my mind before as outspoken and as, I wish I remember the word now, as, you know, something, you know, just as outspoken and not afraid of speaking, whatever. And I was trying to describe to her that I'm not that way. I don't try to be provocative. That's the word. I'm sorry. She said, I'm not as provocative as you. And I tried to explain to her that I don't purposely try to be provocative. And then my daughter-in-law was standing next to us, and she piped up, that's just the way she is. And it is. I've always just spoken. I'm not mean or cruel. My sister, we went around recently in a birthday party, and we shared what we love about each other. And one of my sisters shared about me that I don't have a mean bone in my body. And I don't. I never purposely set out to be mean or cruel to people, say mean or cruel things to people. And I've even seen people who hate what I write on their pages, that they've seen that I don't say mean or cruel things. Some people can think that I'm too dogmatic, or I might come across as harsh because truth can sound harsh. And maybe I don't always say things in the most kind way, but I never set out to be cruel or mean. That's never my intention. And another reason I started these videos is because, and what this woman's comment to me made me think of, when I started teaching women years ago, I started in groups of women. There's about 15 women in a group, and I went through Creative Bees Help Me. We'd go through one chapter and we'd discuss things, and they'd ask me things, and I just tell them point blank, you know, what I thought and how, you know, based on scripture or my experience. And one woman said, you know, you can say anything as long as you say it with a smile. And so when I write, my smile doesn't come through, my personality. And sometimes I write things a little bit more aggressively when I've got something, you know, kind of hot in my head, you know, that I'm worked up about. But most of the time, I'm writing to encourage women towards biblical womanhood, towards godliness, towards God's will for them, because I know it's best. Someone just sent me a long post about how women still don't have equal rights. They still need more freedom for abortion. They need free childcare. They don't feel free, equal with men yet. And blah, blah, blah. You know, it's like they need this, they need that. Until women learn to be content with what they have, you know, they'll never be happy. They'll always be fighting for some right. That's not how what we're called to do. We're not supposed to fight for rights. We fight for our rights, it's on our knees in prayers to the Lord Jesus. Then we speak the truth in love, of course. Older women, you teach younger women biblical womanhood and how to live lives loving God and serving Him and serving others. This is what we're called to do, and this is so desperately needed in our time. So I'm sorry if I come across harsh in my writing. I certainly don't mean to be. It's never my intention. I never mean ill will towards people. Even women preachers that I name call out by name, I try not to do that often. My husband doesn't want that to be my ministry. I don't mean ill will towards them. I just want women to be aware that they're not supposed to be preaching, and I wish they would stop. They're not supposed to be in churches preaching to men. That's not our calling. So it's never my intention to hurt anyone or offend anyone. I know truth offends, and I know a lot of the things I teach offend, but that's just God's word. You know, his word will offend, and we must be bold enough to teach it, even if it does offend. So anyway, that's why I started making videos. I don't really love making them. I don't make a lot, but that's why I make them. For those of you, the few of you who do like them. Bye-bye.